You're listening to the Hour of the Time. And what a time it is, folks. You're going to hear some disturbing comments, commentary, and a call to arms tonight. The United States Congress, in a blatant act of treason, has outlawed 17 types of assault weapons. And one more move toward the enslavement of the American people. Don't go away. Today, the United States Congress outlawed over 17 types of what they call assault weapons. There really is no such thing as an assault weapon, ladies and gentlemen, as a class of any type of weapon, firearms, knives, whatever you wish to categorize. There is no such thing, for no weapon is an assault weapon unless it is used in an assault. In the bill, cleverly written, is a provision including all types of weapons which can automatically or, in some instances, with the help of your hand, reload another round after firing the weapon. This includes lever action rifles and shotguns. It includes pump shotguns. In other words, ladies and gentlemen, with the stroke of a pen today, they've outlawed all weapons except for bolt action, single shot rifles. Now, supposedly, we have not seen this final bill in its final state of passage as yet. But supposedly there's a grandfather clause which allows you to keep whatever weapons you may have. I'd say it doesn't make any difference because I don't know anyone who's going to give up their weapons no matter what these traitors pass. And listen, listen, folks, very carefully. For tonight, we're going to put things in a proper perspective. A perspective which cannot, should not, and I tell you now, will not be ignored.
All of a sudden, in the middle of the night, there's a loud knock on your door. Behind, something's not right.
Your arms. We're here from the government to help you. And I'm from the IRS with a power attack. If you've got a complaint, then you're the best.
get out of this house. Surrender your guns. If you do not go, the federal way to the right level. You're going to be in trouble.
New world order. World of dream camp night. Utopia. General Albert Pike. The money founder of the Ku Klux Klan. Engineer of the Messiah. Master plan.
The brotherhood of man.
Pike said, Lucifer's God. The Klux Klan. And put the thing to the mark. With your right hand. While we're all dancing to the drums of the Buffalo Pike, let's prepare it for another new attack.
Seek high.
Order out of chaos, depression, inflation, greed, panic, and resignation.
No surprise.
Creation. In fight, black and white, program, and education.
Come at this! You're surrounded! By the UN in white and blue, the ATF, the men in black, from the One World Order.
But it's not new. Iron Mountain, computer beasts, and cattle mutilations. Black projects, UFOs, and weird genetic combinations. The Nazi doctors didn't die. Come on, get him. They came here with the OSS through Operation Paperclip. National ID, debit card? Yeah. Vaccination biochip, milk carton kits, genetic engineering. Clinton Center has a plan for you and your own good. Sure. And Adolf Hitler's Robin Hood.
Sieg Heil.
The sun is mind manipulation. Inciting riots is crisis creation. Biochip implantation. Vaccinate your kid for UN identification.
This is a test for all of us. So I have today just one simple request. A comprehensive package of healthcare benefits that are always there and can never be taken away. Never be taken away.
Atmospheric. Social illusion. Media hype. Plan confusion. Masonic religion. It's a liar. Got you praying for a Luciferian Messiah.
And here's the truth of the matter, ladies and gentlemen, in the Democrat and Chronicle, Rochester, New York, Thursday, March 31st, 1994. U.S. leads world in exporting arms. U.S. leads world in exporting arms. Its $59 billion in sales takes top spot from the Soviets. The Associated Press, Washington, D.C. The United States doubled its share of world arms exports between 1981 and 1991 from 19.3% to 37.8% and swept past the former Soviet Union into first place. The U.S. Arms Control and Disarmament Agency reported yesterday, and they consider the American people to be a danger. The United States exported $59 billion in arms during 1987 to 1991, with $35 billion, or 60%, going to developing countries. In that period, Saudi Arabia purchased $5.1 billion in arms, Israel $5 billion in arms, and Taiwan $3 billion in arms, all to pit the people of the world against each other while they enslave us all. The only people on the face of this earth able to stop what's coming are the American people, who are the only people in the world legally armed. Until today, that is. Actually, United States arms exports declined by almost 34% between 1989 and 1991, while world arms sales were dropping 53%. The result, the agency said in a report, was that the United States share doubled, while the Soviet Union's share declined from 43% in 1986 to 26% in 1991, and Ronald Reagan dared to call the Soviet Union the evil empire. I told you years ago, at the highest levels, they're all the same. The largest recipients of arms from the Soviet Union, which broke up in December 1991, were Afghanistan, India, and Iraq. The Middle East consistently is the largest purchaser of weapons. Gotta keep that conflict going, folks, to fool you blithering idiots who believe in prophecy in the Battle of Armageddon. Totally and completely neutralized. You see, if you believe this is all brought about by the hand of God instead of the manipulation of those who believe they have the only truly mature minds, then you are no threat to anyone but yourself. Although imports declined from $31 billion in 1984 to $11 billion in 1991 in the Middle East, however, Middle Eastern countries contracted to purchase $17 billion in arms in 1991, an increase of $4 billion from 1989. Do you really believe there's going to be peace in the Middle East? Have you read your paper today? Are you buying the scam? While they're telling you they're signing peace treaties, they are selling arms to both sides. So that as soon as the money that bought the peace is dried up, war can once again rear its ugly head. Only this time it will be much worse than ever before. And the Jews, as usual, buy into the scam, thinking that everybody's doing this to save Israel. The fate of the Jews in the New World Order will be the same as the fate of the Christians and of the blacks and of anyone else who is considered to be undesirable. And one of the greatest ironies is that the followers of the Prophet Muhammad and the followers of the God Yahweh or Jehovah in Israel are fighting each other, trying their best to destroy each other. All in the name of fulfilling prophecy. Hitler used prophecy to subjugate Europe. And when all the prophecy is fulfilled, and the 1,000 years of peace appears, and the phony Christ rears his head and declares that he is the Son of God, once again returned to this earth, the followers of both of those religions will be put to the sword. Are you listening, sheeple? Are you listening to me, sheeple? I hope so. Saudi Arabia was by far the largest weapons importer in the region, accounting for $29.7 billion from 1987 to 1991. Iraq was second with $16.3 billion. Iran, $8.8 billion. Syria, $5.9 billion. Israel, $5 billion. And Egypt, $4.2 billion. While George Bush was dropping the phrase New World Order, he was secretly arming Saddam Hussein. He gave Saddam Hussein the go-ahead to invade Kuwait and then instigated the fraud called Desert Storm. Kept you all very much entertained, watching smart bombs go down smokestacks. When it was all over, you found out that they weren't any more accurate in Desert Storm than they were in Vietnam or in Korea. 70% of everything they fired missed their target. China, a frequent target of United States criticism, held a 5% share of weapons exports to developing countries in 1991. The leading exporters were, in order, the United States, the Soviet Union, the United Kingdom, West Germany, France, China, Canada, Israel, Czechoslovakia, North Korea, the Netherlands, Italy, Poland, Brazil, and Bulgaria. And on the same page of this newspaper, the editors, in their utter contempt for the sheeple, printed this story. Brady Law prevents 1,605 from buying handguns. The Washington Post, Washington, in its first month of operation, the Brady Law, a national five-day waiting period and background check, has prevented at least 1,605 buyers from purchasing handguns, including fugitives and felons convicted of armed robbery, murder, and manslaughter, according to preliminary statistics from 15 states and cities. 44 fugitives are people facing outstanding warrants were denied guns, including one South Carolina man wanted for sexual assault who was arrested in the gun store. Gun control supporters lauded the early statistics as a definitive but conservative indicator of the law's effectiveness. We checked the statistics, and this is a blatant lie. You think you're safe in your homes? Do you really think that what's coming is good for you? Have you bought the socialist lie? Welcome to Ruby Ridge and Waco, Texas. How many of you out there are running around chasing your tail? A lot of you. How many of you subscribe to the Patriot Facts Network and the Patriot Information Network? How many of you read the bullshit stories like the one I'm going to read you now, which is a total lie? But they're all over the place. They keep you stirred up, running around, chasing your tail, doing everything except what you should be doing. After Waco, Feds Define Cult by Steve Forsman. Following the violent destruction by federal agents of the Branch Davidian compound near Waco, Texas, officials of the Clinton government set out to define what exactly a cult is so that such undesirable groups may be more easily identified and dealt with by the government in the future. The Attorney General's office under Janet Reno established the Cult Awareness Task Force for this purpose. They came up with the following definition. Quote, a cultist is one who has a strong belief in the Bible and the second coming of Christ, who has a high level of financial giving to a Christian cause, who homeschools his children, who has accumulated survival foods and has a strong belief in the Second Amendment, and who distrusts big government, unquote. Defending the federal assault on the compound, Clinton spoke of the rise in this sort of fanaticism all across the world, warning that we may have to confront it again. He added, quote, I hope very much that others who will be tempted to join cults and become involved with people like David Koresh will be deterred by the horrible scenes they have seen over the last 7 weeks, unquote. The only thing in this whole piece of trash is the last statement. Clinton's statement is the only statement that is true in this thing. I watch what goes through the Patriot Network. I watch what spins around in the so-called Patriot community. And I'm telling you right now, there are more fools in the Patriot community than out there with the sheeple. And you'd better wake up. And you'd better stop it. We've been warning you about a coming economic collapse. How many of you have been keeping track of what's really happening? How many of you understand that the dollar is sick? It is so sick that the following is the truth about what's happening, ladies and gentlemen. You better prepare yourself. The New York Times byline, Thomas L. Friedman, U.S. allies buy dollars to boost ailing buck. Move may also bolster Clinton. Washington, the United States teamed with the central banks of 15 nations Wednesday to buy dollars in a global campaign designed to show investors that the Clinton administration is serious about maintaining the value of the ailing American currency. Did you hear what I just said? I want you to make sure that you stay on your couch tonight. Don't do anything about it. Whatever you do, don't prove to anybody that you're smart. I continue. It was the first coordinated intervention since August 1992 and involved the Treasury Department and the Federal Reserve joining with the central banks of Germany, France, Japan, and 12 other countries. The move was planned in a series of secret phone calls overnight. Senior U.S. Treasury officials said the main objective of the Federal Reserve's purchase of dollars Friday and Wednesday's much larger intervention to support the dollar was to counter what they saw as a widening perception in global currency markets that the administration was ready to allow the dollar to drift lower, which means inflation, just exactly as I predicted. And I will tell you this, within the next few weeks, there will be another raise in the rate of interest. It's not hard to predict, ladies and gentlemen. All you have to do is pay attention. Widening perception in global currency markets that the administration was ready to allow the dollar to drift lower, either as a matter of policy or of benign neglect. But the real reason is whether this kind of market intervention alone, and the question is whether it can change the mood in trading rooms around the world or whether it will take more fundamental policy changes. What is striking in talking with traders is that their loss of confidence in the dollar does not seem rooted only in the trade friction between Washington and Tokyo or other ephemeral economic issues. It seems also to be fed by a more general loss of confidence in President Clinton's handling of foreign policy, the months of distractions over his and his wife's personal finances, and widespread uncertainties about the fate of health care and the ability of the Federal Reserve to continue raising interest rates despite mounting political pressures against the moves from the White House. And tomorrow, a woman will file charges in court. Criminal sexual charges against William Clinton. Not surprisingly, some doubt that Wednesday's intervention will be enough to firm up the American currency for long, although no one is quite sure how long it will be before traders test the United States' resolve. The intervention certainly buoyed the dollar for a time, said Richard Whitten, a top currency expert at Goldman Sachs and Company. If not for this intervention, the dollar would have gone much lower. But if the Federal Reserve wants to support the dollar at this general level, it will require more intervention. Are you listening? When are you people going to get your heads out of your ass? How many of you were condemning the Japanese because they bought American businesses and American property and American real estate? Just how many of you fools understood that Americans sold it to them? How many of you understand that all these little cul-de-sacs and things you have your head spinning around in make no difference whatsoever? We are at war. The elite, the Illumined Ones, declared war against us many, many years ago. They have taken our nation away from us. You have no rights. As a matter of routine policy, the police break down the doors of American citizens across this country on a daily basis, seize their property, strip search their family members, including their women and children, and all bodily cavities, seize their property, all of their property, bank accounts, homes, RVs, weapons, clothing, everything. The kitchen sink, and auction it off to the highest bidder without any charges ever being pressed. without any due process, without any judgment in a court of law. And you claim that if you spin around in these little cul-de-sacs, you're going to change something. I say you've lost your marbles. You're still living in fantasy land, and while you may claim that you are awake and that you are a patriot and that you understand what's going on, I say that you are a blithering idiot. You know nothing. The United States of America is gone. It's gone. The Constitution, the Bill of Rights are not in effect. The government in Washington, D.C. is a counterfeit, unconstitutional, enemy country that is waging a war against the American people. Most of you don't understand it, never have understood it, and probably never will understand it until it is too late and the chains are around your ankles and you are shackled to a computer in a system of debt out of which you will never extricate yourself or your progeny. You will live in a one-world totalitarian socialist order where you will pretend to work and the state will pretend to pay you. You will be happily entertained with great, magnificent gladiatorial contests, which you already see on television and in Super Bowls and in world soccer matches. And I could go on and on and on. And you sit mesmerized in front of the great brainwashing tool, the eye of Big Brother, which sits in your living room and desensitizes you, brainwashes you, and teaches you how to live as a zombie in the New World Order. What is wrong with you? Have you been watching Big Brother's eye in your living room for too long? I know from talking to many of you that most of you have never had an original thought in your entire life, and it's becoming very doubtful whether you ever will. We are at war. You are either going to march peacefully into the New World Order and place the chains around your own ankles, or you are going to wake up and reestablish this republic, reclaim your freedoms, arrest every traitor who is alive in this country, try them for treason, and if they are found guilty, hang them from the nearest lamppost. If this is not done, then you cannot cry about your fate. You cannot whine, you cannot wail, you cannot pretend to be patriots. You're nothing but a flock of foolish sheep following the Judas goat to the shearing rooms, and from there you will march into the slaughterhouse. It is a fact. It is not a guess. It is not a prediction. It's not a prophecy. It is a fact. Thank you. The ultimate hypocrisy of sending your children off to fight a war in the Middle East, a war which has nothing whatsoever to do with the United States of America, patting them on the ass, wishing them well. The ultimate hypocrisy of claiming that you love them, sending them off to die, so that you don't have to confront the truth. You haven't got the guts to fight for your own country in your own. It is the ultimate, most unbelievable hypocrisy that you would do something like that. Most of you would never go fight without the threat of prison hanging over your heads, without the threat of being condemned by your friends and neighbors as being unpatriotic or against the government, yet you will not lift a finger to save your country in your own country. But you watch. When Clinton gets ready to send troops to Haiti, to South Africa, or to Bosnia, or to the Middle East, you will round up your sons and daughters and pat them on the ass and send them on their way. Don't tell me you won't. I've seen it happen all my life. Nobody asked me if I was afraid when I went to Vietnam to fight, but everybody is so concerned about the danger that I am in by making these broadcasts and by declaring myself nightly over the air. What hypocrisy! What liars! Americans, show me one. I don't see many Americans in this country. I don't see many people who even understand what an American is. I see a bunch of hypocritic, scared, lying little sheep who go to church on Sunday and stab their neighbors in the back Monday through Saturday, week after week after week. Now I'm going to outline for you what you should be doing. And if you don't do it, I'm going to turn this radio broadcast into a UFO New Age freako show, and I'm going to have a lot of fun, and I'm going to laugh at you every single night of the rest of my life. I'm sick and tired of hearing your bullshit. I'm sick and tired of hearing you cry. I'm sick and tired of you leaning on me, waiting for me to save the world. When the time comes, I will do my part, and I will fight for my freedoms. And you can make up your own mind what you're going to do. But if you're not going to help me fight for our creator-endowed rights and for what all the men and women who have died to preserve those rights for us throughout the history of this country, you had better not get anywhere near me, because I will consider you as part of the enemy. And that is the truth. There's a woman named Linda Thompson who has more guts in her little finger than most Americans have ever known in their whole life. When others fail to act, she never fails to act, and you can call her what you want. You can listen to all the detractors who will tell you that her films are not right or whatever. Nevertheless, she did more to draw attention to the massacre in Waco, Texas, by the lying scum murderers who committed it, than anybody else. She has no background in military training or military tactics. She doesn't understand really the technology that we face or the enemy that we're going up against, and therefore she sometimes makes mistakes. Nevertheless, she's on the right track while the rest of you are digging holes in the sand in which to plant your silly heads. She has issued a call to arms in September. She has sent an ultimatum by certified mail to every member of the United States House and Senate by April the 21st, 1994. She calls all militia units to convene at 8 a.m. Monday, September 19th, 1994 in Washington, D.C., armed and in uniform, to deliver the Declaration of Independence to the White House and to enforce the ultimatum. The militia will arrest congressmen who have failed to uphold their oaths of office, who then will be tried for treason by citizens' courts. The reason that you should be in militia units armed and in uniform is simply because if you are arrested or captured, you must, by law, be treated as a prisoner of war and not as a criminal. And I'm telling you now, and I'm telling you, Linda Thompson, you are making a big mistake. A big mistake. You have the right idea. You are thinking, you are taking action, but it is the wrong action. And I'm going to tell you why now, and I'm going to point you in the right direction. But I'm going to tell you again, as I always have, don't believe what you hear here. Don't believe what I tell you until you can confirm it in your own research, in your own right, by your own study of what we face, what we have at our disposal, and the proper way to win this type of war. Linda Thompson, I love you, and in no way do I mean this as a personal attack upon you or yours. I want you to understand that. If you rally militia units and march on Washington, D.C. with arms, the sheeple of this nation will cry for military action to be taken upon you because they are stupid and do not understand what you're doing. The public will be behind the government as they mow you down and kill every single one of you where you stand. The technology you face cannot be overcome by militia units carrying rifles in uniform marching on Washington, D.C. This must not be attempted. You have no control of the air. You have no artillery support. You do not have the support of the general public, which are a mass of stupid sheep. You do not have the support of the press, If you do such a thing, you will not even have the support of the law. Now, each and every one of you out there, I want you to make copies of this tape and distribute it around this country. And if you don't have the means to make a copy, order the tapes from us. I don't care how many copies you make, just don't sell them. Distribute them freely. Patriots must not make this mistake. You must form your militia units. You must prepare on a local level to defend your communities, cities, and states, as the militia was intended to do. The days are gone when you can march out as an army on a battlefield and face an enemy along a front line. Militia units will not survive any such attempt at traditional warfare. Our country is gone. Our Constitution and Bill of Rights are gone, ladies and gentlemen. We are already at war, whether you like it or not, whether you want to admit it or not, or whether you want to confront it. Your responsibility is on your local level. You must identify the traitors at your local level. You must organize on a local level. Everything must be done legally and lawfully under the Constitution and the legal and lawful laws of your state. Pay no heed to the federal government, which is a counterfeit enemy foreign government. Identify targets on a local level. When they make an overt move, and I mean overt, another move like Waco, Texas, or an obvious, overt, and truthful merger, which has already been done in secret with the United Nations, or with Canada or Mexico to form a region under the United Nations, you are well within your rights and within the law to destroy those targets and take military control with your militia of your local city, county, and state and reestablish what was guaranteed to us by the Constitution of the United States of America, a republican form of government, and you are within your rights and within the law to defend that republican form of government against anyone who comes against you. But bear in mind, they will come with a technology that cannot be met by two armies facing off across a field. Any war which we fight as patriots to maintain our freedom and reestablish the Constitution and Bill of Rights as the supreme law of the land, legally and lawfully under the law, will be fought as a guerrilla warfare on a local level, or you stand no chance of winning. I admire Linda Thompson's courage. I admire her willingness to act when the rest of the nation stands picking their nose. But she needs to take a turn in the direction that I have outlined tonight. I issue, as I have done before, this call to arms. Arm yourselves. Pay no attention to any legislation limiting, regulating, or calling for the registration of firearms or outlawing firearms. It is unconstitutional and illegal. Under the second article in amendment to the Constitution of the United States of America, we the people are authorized, allowed, and have a right to form militia units to protect our communities and our states. You must do this now. And you must make a public showing of what you are doing. Do not in any manner make a public showing of your true total strength, or of the source of your strength, or of how many or what kind of weapons you have. But you must make a show of weapons. You must prepare yourselves and your families. You must have food supplies. You must have all of the accoutrements of survival, because we are at war, and the war will disintegrate into a shooting match eventually. But not by a march on Washington, D.C., by patriots carrying rifles, facing the technological might of the greatest Army, Navy, and Air Force in the world, which now are functioning as the police force of world government, the United Nations, and will not hesitate to destroy you. You must be as the wind when confronting the enemy. You must never confront the enemy unless you know that you can beat the enemy. And then you must be swift and ruthless and leave nothing that belongs to the enemy intact so that it can be used ever again, unless you can use it and you carry it away. These people are traitors. They will have no mercy upon you. And you must learn to do the same. I don't like having to do what I'm doing tonight, but this had to be done. And I've given you this message before, not as pointed, not as direct, not as chastising, but you did not get the message. You did not get the message. Now, all of you that are playing at being Americans, and all of you that are playing at being loyal to the Constitution, you better go hide somewhere. Because there are many of us out here who are very, very serious. Very serious. Form your units. Make sure that your leaders have the authority of the unit. Follow their directions, and if you can't take orders from your leaders, get out of the unit. Don't give them problems, and don't challenge their leadership. If you're so insecure you must be a leader, then go form your own unit. But you'd better be a good leader, or no one will follow you. Make sure that you never, ever break the law. Make sure that you never steal. Make sure that you never, ever murder. Make sure that you are organized and have rules and regulations. Make sure that you have officers and that you follow their orders, as long as they are legal and lawful orders. And that you never do anything illegal and use the excuse that you were following orders. We are Americans and we believe in the principles and ideals upon which this country was founded, or we are hypocrites and liars and scum. Now, you make your choice. I have made mine. I am willing to die for my freedom. I am willing to sit in jail as long as I need to sit in jail, if they ever can find any legal reason to put me in jail and lay their hands on me in order to get me there, because I will not go peacefully. I will never give up my guns, nor my child. Nor will I allow my child's brain to be corrupted by their stupid, sickening Marxist schools. We're going to take this country back. We're going to reestablish the supreme law of the land, legally and lawfully. The law is on our side. They are the traitors. And as Linda said, they will ultimately be arrested. They will be tried legally and lawfully. And if they are found guilty, they will be hung, I guarantee you. You had better prepare. You'd better prepare your family, and you'd better get serious. If you're not willing to die for your freedoms, then stop playing around with the rest of us. If you don't think what you're losing is important enough to fight for, then get the hell out of our way and don't play with the rest of us. If you're not ready and willing to identify the traitors in your area and identify targets which you must act to take out and destroy the moment they make the overt act of warfare which will justify such action on our part, then get out of the way and don't play with the rest of us, for we are serious. We are deadly serious. As many stupid Marxists and communists and blithering idiot illuminated ones are going to find out. And I don't think it's that far off in the future. Linda Thompson, if I have offended you in any way by this broadcast tonight, I sincerely beg your forgiveness and issue my humblest of apologies, for that was not my intention whatsoever. I love you. I respect you and admire you for what you have done for this country. And I look forward to what you will do for this country in the future. But I hope that you will rethink this march on Washington. And I hope the rest of you will get your heads on straight and aligned and stop following these little stupid deceptions that keep you running around chasing your tails. To arms. Form your militia units to arms. Our freedoms are worth fighting for, or they are not. You understand what's happening, or you don't. You must continue to educate those who do not. The best package in the world that you can ever find are the treason documents which we have spent years researching and accumulating and which we have made available for you. If you want information on it, send a self-addressed stamped envelope, number 10 size, with $1 to P.O. Box 1420, Sholo, Arizona, 85901. And this address will be repeated again at the end of the show, so have your pencils and paper ready. I'm not going to waste valuable airtime with it again. If you would like to purchase it outright, it's over 630 pages of absolute documentation, United States government documents, documents of the United States Senate and House of Representatives, documents of the State Department, documents of the Disarmament Agency, documents of the plans to bring together the armies, navies, and air force of the United States of America and Russia to form the World Police Force in our government documents. If you want those documents without waiting for an info pack, send us $85 and we'll send them right off to you. I don't care how many times you copy these documents, but do it and educate the sheeple with them, for this proves that no one can deny what we are telling you tonight once you have these documents in your hands. And if I've scared the hell out of you, that's good. It's about time somebody did. And it's about time you wake up. It's about time you get off your butts. It's about time you get a copy of the Constitution and Bill of Rights and read it. It's about time you start reading your newspapers and understand that the Constitution and Bill of Rights have been thrown in the trash can, as every issue of every newspaper in this country proves on a daily basis. Take the documents to your local sheriff, to your police chief, to the officers of the National Guard, and don't forget the non-commissioned officers. For if the officers turn against the Constitution, it will be the non-commissioned officers who will have to tell the men to shoot that officer. They have all taken an oath to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and soon we will find out who will respect that oath and who will not. to arms. Good night, and God bless you all.
Everybody knows.